Welcome to Southern Minneapolis Eats Takeout Edition. And it turns out there's actually some really good food in this area.
I called Buckboard this morning and I said he was wondering if it was possible to get a biscuit instead of the toast. And I hear it go, "Hey, can we do biscuit instead of toast?"
Perfect.
It's so good.
Is that toast?
Toast.
Toast.
Yeah. But we woke up early this morning and I thought, I know a way we can burn up this extra time. Let's go pick up food from Buckboard.
Okay. Okay. Okay then, there.
Go for some biscuits and gravy.
Here you go. I'm not sure what this is. This
dish that's ours. That's
is a sham.
Sham's skillet. What it is a,
you know, shamalama ding dong.
It's basically like, wow, look at that. They really loaded up with it.
Oh, that looks great.
So it's like a hash basically, but it's got a Polish kielbasa on there, and then hollandaise.
Happy hollandaise.
Oh, some toast.
It's basically got all the meats.
We have the meats.
Cause I have the one that's farmers and it's just meats and a couple of vegetables.
Yeah.
Vegetables.
He can't even say it. He doesn't even know what they are.
That kielbasa is really good.
Yeah, it's super good.
That's what struck me the first time I went to Buckboard. I was like, wow, what are they doing this sausage here?
It's so good.
I'm gonna try one of these sausages.
Biscuits and gravy. Just tastes like my childhood.
Mmm.
Yeah, did you try that kielbasa?
Mm-hmm.
It's unbelievable.
Try mine. Try mine, Tim.
Try my
your kielbasa?
No.
Well, we're like,
I was saying that one, try it.
You wanna try my sausage?
That's evolution right there. Your body knows.
Yeah, it's like what?
I better thicken up for this winter.
I hear you.
You got it right?
Yeah.
You did so much.
She might get a little stomach ache. Listen, shut up. Oh God. I'm done. Ugh. That was delicious.
Yes. We just picked up some food from the Northern Tap House and we're gonna take it back to Darren's place and enjoy lunch. But before we get there, we're probably gonna dig into the cheese curds, let's be honest. Chris, you're from here. Can you explain to the folks from back home like what exactly a cheese curd is?
It's deep fried cheese curds. But like the curds off the cheese. Own. It's like the top that's skimmed off of milk.
I think it's like when you first make cheese, just like in its most natural form, it comes out as curds, which is not a very appetizing term. They should really rebrand that. But they're delicious. If you eat them as is, they kind of make your teeth squeak a little bit. So a lot of people call them squeak cheese. But the real pros then deep fry that. It's the one thing I feel like we have in common with the Midwest is that we both celebrate fried cheese.
Oh, look at the way the sun is hitting that greasy curd.
Anybody else get this same salad?
What's up?
I have the balsamic one.
Look what I ordered, then what these a-holes ordered.
Cheese curds.
When you can't decide, don't.
Oh, did you get them all?
That's why we went back, because this rocked my world last night.
They are good there.
And I sure have become really a big fan of Brussels sprouts over the last few years.
They
must be getting old. I like sprouts. So during the pandemic, we're doing a takeout edition. So this is, I'm calling this Southern Minneapolis Eats takeout edition.
I got myself a jalapeno and bacon and cheddar jack infused burger.
Yeah.
Here's something we do in Pittsburgh. Our claim to fame is we put fries on our things.
That's the truffle.
All right, this just in, we figured some things out.
That's a lot harder.
Mm-hmm.
We had some of these yesterday. They're so good.
Yeah, that's the right thing to do.
These are the Tap House tater tots.
Oh, tots.
It's a whole experience.
Ooh.
That's good.
They are really
I'm going to take your word for it.
Oh, you want to taste it?
No, thanks.
Do you like balsamic?
I actually do.
It's really good chicken.
Do you want some, puppy? Do you?
Bella's a baker.
Bella?
You want any of the fish taco, Chris?
I'm good, thanks.
Chris doesn't do seafood.
That's true. This doesn't count as seafood, does it?
I guess there's differences.
Lake foods.
Probably the best walleye tacos I've ever had. Incidentally, the only walleye tacos I've ever had.
I didn't go fried. So that's something, right?
You did it.
That's progress. They brought me here last time I was in town, and it is my first stop once we got to town. Artisan sports bar food, let's call it.
Yes.
It is Super Bowl Sunday at the Rust House. Every Super Bowl party needs some snacks. And my specialty is the lazy man's cooking. Let me do it one more time.
Yeah, you rolled the R.
I know. Lazy. Okay. It is Super Bowl Sunday at the Rust House, and they've been kind enough to let me take over their kitchen. Because every Super Bowl party needs some snacks. Now, I specialize in lazy man's cooking, and today we'll be making buffalo chicken dip. One of the best things about this recipe is that everything's ready to go. I even traditionally used canned chicken. Again, the lazy man's way. Got a little cheddar cheese here of your choice. I like sharp cheddar, so that's what I chose. Cream cheese, which I've already softened in the microwave. Buffalo sauce of your choice. I like Frank's. Ranch dressing of your choice. And then finally, to serve, some cracker of your choice, and I prefer Ritz chips. Let's start mixing it together. So you just want to get a skillet heating a little bit. Again, we're not really cooking, we're just blending and melting. Chicken goes in, buffalo sauce goes in, as much or as little as you like. We're in the Midwest, so I don't want to add too much spice. Next up, ranch dressing. Traditionally, I just like to use a little bit less ranch dressing than I use buffalo sauce. It ends up looking about like this. So the next step is add the cream cheese. 2 blocks of cream cheese for this recipe, which makes it extra healthy. Next up, we're just gonna toss a couple handfuls of the shredded cheddar in there. Now we'll mix that in. All we have to do now is transfer it to the baking dish, cover it with another layer of shredded cheddar, pop it in the oven, and then try to be patient.
What?
So now we're just gonna transfer it into a baking dish. Kind of spread it around evenly in the dish here. Next, we're just going to cover it with a layer of the shredded cheddar. Look at that, I almost eyeballed it perfectly. Looks like our oven's preheated. Should we pop it in? Now we're just gonna leave it in there for about 15 minutes. We'll check back in. All right, it should be ready. Let's see. Now we just need a taste tester. And I think I know just the guy for the job.
And here I am.
Oh!
What do we have here?
Why don't you go ahead and put this 350 degree dip in your...
Oh yeah, let me just reach in.
No, with crackers, please.
Oh, did you make these?
I didn't. Those are Ritz chips. They're awesome, right?
Mmm.
You take a bite of the cracker before you dip it, huh? Always. Is that how you do it in Wisconsin?
Always. Well, it looks hot. Okay.
Well, it just came out, so it's still kind of bubbling. Daryl's gonna give us his professional opinion.
Well, it smells right. Is there cheese in here?
Just a touch. You're gonna want to blow really on that quite a bit.
Right,
don't do it.
Don't
do it.
Small plate.
Oh, pungent.
You need Daddy to blow on that for you?
There you go.
Stop watching. I can't do it when you watch me. So.
Okay, I'll turn this one.
It's really hot.
Don't do it. Oh, he's doing it.
Weirdest shot. Give
him a glass of water.
Mmm. It's creamy. It's cheesy.
Buffalo-y. What?
Tell
Buffalo-y.
Us about the notes you. Sets.
Okey.
Okey.
Okey. Like a okey afterbirth.
Oh.
You're up.
You should have blown on it.
Here we go.
Hot. You're gonna waste your glue on it.
We gotta.
Okay.
Let's go.
Gotta
ooh, that's tasty.
I'm excited.
We are going to be pretty, pretty, pretty chicken. Pretty, 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 pretty. Very lucky birdie, kitty, pretty. Yeah, boy, dear, dear, buddy, dear.
I mean, that's actually your people, right?
Right.
So,
yeah, that's
right.
It's not even mockery, it's just his heritage.
Bork, bork, bork.
And sorrow, I've seen trouble all my days. I the place where I was born and raised. The place where he was born and raised. For 6 long years I've been in trouble.
All right, well, you're the season pros.
Okay.
What do you get? Yes,
all right. We have to get cheese curds because they rock.
Okay.
But we'll probably need two orders
just
of that.
Double up on that.
Yeah, double up on that. The pickle supreme is really good.
They have to try it. Okay.
Yeah, I can't not get a burger when we come.
I know, I gotta do that too.
In fact, I'm gonna get the green olive burger.
Okay.
One of the more creative burgers I've ever seen. They got all these creative burgers.
What do you think, America? What should I get?
It's Greg Timmerman. I'm here with him and his wife, Kate, owners of my favorite restaurant in Lakeville, Minnesota, The Firehouse.
Grill.
Firehouse Grill, one of my favorite restaurants south of the Twin Cities. We are in New Market, Minnesota right now. And when Darren and I discovered this place, we started coming here about 3 to 4 times a week. We instantly fell in love with their creative burgers and just everything on the menu. You guys have been so good to us throughout the years. We filmed part of Think a Little Less here. Chance was in his element behind the bar. So this is a real treat for me because I haven't been inside a restaurant in months. As always, I can't wait to eat.
All right.
Can we follow you into the kitchen and see how you do what you do?
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Awesome.
For sure.
Midnight confessions, whiskey therapy sessions, buying drinks to buy some time beneath the stained glass neon lights while the bartender listens. As long as you're tipping, it's a place to heal and a place to hurt after a long week of hell. It's like Sunday church. You'll hear dirty jokes and the gospel truth. A jukebox choir singing in a corner booth. We're here every week and bring your burdens, bring your pain. Everybody's welcome at the Church of the Dive Bar Saints. Yeah. Well, the bar top's been baptized in spilled beer and cheap wine. Ooh, this congregation doesn't judge, but they'll take your keys if you had too much. They got your back here. That's why we keep coming back here. It's a place to heal and a place to hurt after a
hell,
it's like Sunday.
Well, you know, when you're passionate about the product.
Come on in.
Oh,
yeah.
I think that'll do. I believe this is yours, sir.
Oh, my Lord.
This is yours?
Mm-hmm.
All right, we'll switch it up.
Cool.
Look at this work of art. I mean, who thinks that's to it. Put cream cheese and green olives in a burger? Kate Timmerman, that's who.
Oh.
Oh,
you guys whip this out. The
tater tots. Well, I mean, just the beef itself is really good. Something. It starts there, you know.
Right.
Then, like, you don't even have to, you know, like, go crazy with the seasoning. You got really good beef. And then on top of that, you get the sweetness of the cream cheese, and then you know, kind of like the salty tanginess of the green olives, and even that toasted bun is so good.
Oh, the bun is incredible.
The whole thing, it's just, it's a masterpiece. It is.
Pretty excited. How do I get all this in there?
Open big. Like a python.
Oh my god, it's just juice that we're looking at.
Mm-hmm.
The juice and the fun. Oh my gosh.
I need to dislocate that.
Talk to me about it.
Oh, if I can.
Are you pleased with your decision?
I made the right choice.
Have you ever felt this way before?
No,
never felt
not about not about food or a person or anything. As good as it can go. I've never loved anything this much.
Four alarm. You got jalapenos, the
onion straws and what else is it?
Like pepper jack and sriracha aioli.
Yeah.
Oh man.
Ooh, yeah, it's so good.
Here we go. That's not very Midwestern of you.
Yeah. You're gonna start
and you're gonna spend time on an airplane tomorrow, huh?
I'm glad I'm
trying to make sure
everybody's happy. I'm glad I'm staying home.
I got it all worked out. Could be disastrous.
Ooh. There's a pickle in here. Pickle with the ham and cream cheese.
I'll make an exception.
Try it?
Yeah.
All right. Cheers.
Mm.
Yeah, I'm not a pickle guy, but this changed everything.
What a perfect conclusion to our gluttonous weekend.
Absolutely.
Folks, do yourself a flavor and come to the Firehouse Grill in New Market, Minnesota. You'll thank me later.
How did you do that with a straight face?
I have dined sufficiently.
And it has a few of my favorite things on it.
That's how you take a bite of a burger.
Uh-oh.
Oh, yeah.
That's the sight of pure satisfaction, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh,